Lisa's on the line from Costa Mesa, California. Our next caller. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Leo. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing pretty well, except I have a question.
Yeah.
I have a Chromebook, which I love because I don't do that much on the computer and, you know, shop and check my mail and Facebook and stuff like that.
Yay! I've been telling everybody, forget the Mac and the PC, get a Chromebook.
Exactly. My husband got it for me for Christmas 2 years ago.
He's
and
a
actually.
Smart man.
He's on it more than I am, and I'm mostly on my mini iPad. I wish I would have gotten a bigger iPad, but it works okay.
But those are both great solutions, much less complexity, and they do what you want to do, right?
Exactly. Well, the question that I have is my son had been using it on vacation, and he liked it, but I went to Fry's, and they had something called the Acer Cloudbook, and it says that it's a Celeron N3050. It has Windows 10 and 365... No, Windows 10 Office for a year, I guess. What's the difference between a Cloudbook and a Chromebook?
It's the operating system. The Cloudbook is a Windows 10 laptop.
Ah.
Don't get that. Acer, well, unless you need Windows. So I'm glad you brought this up because it's become a standard rant of mine. For years, you really had just a couple of choices. If you wanted to use a computer, you had to have a general purpose operating system, Windows, Macintosh, Linux, CPM. But you had an operating system that could do anything because these were very, very expensive and they were really aimed at, a kind of more sophisticated marketplace. But as the world has changed and computers have matured, and mostly as the internet has kind of moved forward, we've discovered that most of what we do is not really on the computer. Most of what we do is on the browser, on the internet. In fact, for most people, email, surfing the web, buying things online, most of what you do, almost all of what you do is in the browser. Very few people need a general purpose operating system anymore. And you know, if you're one of them, you should know. Maybe you're a gamer, for instance. Well, we probably want a Windows PC. If you are launching rocket ships or designing cars, you probably want a computer that has a general purpose operating system so you can run high-end software. But those are very limited, small number of people. They know that they need it. And more importantly, they're going to either have IT support or take the time to learn how to keep the computer secure and running properly. They're going to be willing to put up with the problems that the complexity of a general purpose operating system. The rest of us shouldn't be buying that. Unless you need it, you should be buying a simple operating system that does what you want it to do. Chromebooks, tablets, particularly the iPad, are a perfect example of this. They don't have the security issues of a general purpose operating system at all. They're highly secure. They don't have the reliability issues. They don't get all confused. And in general, they're a lot less expensive because you're not paying for all of the options, the doohickeys, the bells and whistles, the general computer. So I think you're right to get a Chromebook. If your son doesn't need Windows 10, if he says, "Oh no, Mom, I'm going to be gaming," that's different. But if he loves your Chromebook and he's doing the stuff he needs to do on the Chromebook, and even many students, by the way, the Chromebooks are taken off like crazy in schools because they're easily managed, easily maintained, they're less expensive. And students can use them. They get a full keyboard. Now, the good news is there are some really good newer Chromebooks coming out. Acer makes one, the 15-inch. It's just fantastic. Dell has a very good one. HP has some very good ones. These are higher-end hardware, which I like. The reason, you need higher-end hardware if you're running Windows is because a general-purpose operating system uses up more cycles. It has to have more power. So Chromebooks generally, one of the reasons they're less expensive, they don't need as much memory, they don't need as fast a processor, they don't need as much storage. So they're simpler machines too. They're less expensive for that reason. I'd say unless your son knows he wants Windows, get a Chromebook. Acer makes them. Lots of companies make them. I would look online as well. Amazon's number one selling computer now is Chromebooks, easily. They're huge. Chromebooks outsold Macintosh in the last quarter. It's fantastic. Every time I say this, people go, if you need it, you know you need it. If you need Windows, you need a Mac, you know you need it. And you know that you have now a responsibility to become a security expert and to maintain it. That's fine. For the rest of the world, a Chromebook is a very, very good choice. And you're going to see a lot more choices. Now, what's interesting with the Chromebooks, and the reason I want you to get a newer one for your son, is as Google has just added the capability to put the Android store on it, and it will run most Android apps. Suddenly, this has gone from being a device that will only run browser plugins and browser to a device that can run millions of apps designed for Android platform. And that means now there's a huge variety of stuff you can do, including some very, very good games, by the way. And the way they've implemented Android on the Chromebook, in my opinion, makes it secure and safe. So maybe you've heard about some malware issues on Android phones. These are not going to affect your Chromebook. And if anything goes wrong on a Chromebook, it has a nice feature called Power Wash that takes it back to the way it was. And because you're logged into your Google account when you use a Chromebook, it not only takes it back to the way it came from the factory, but it then adds all the modifications, all the apps, everything you installed, it puts it right back to the way it was. And it does it very quickly. Save money, save complexity, save your hair. Don't tear out your hair. I think a Chromebook is an excellent choice.
So when will the new Chromebooks be coming out? Do you have any idea?
They're out now. Okay. They're out now. Just the thing to ask when you get one or to look is to make sure that it has the latest Chrome OS and that it can run Android apps. You really want the Android App Store.
Okay, I want to make sure that it can run the Android App Store, and it has to be like a newer one in the last couple of months.
Yeah, and as I said, Acer has a very good one. Samsung has some very good ones. Your Best Buy may not have all of the choices. That's why I think it's a good idea to look online, too.
Okay.
I'm so glad you called. Yeah, don't get a Windows machine.
No, yeah, he keeps giving me a birthday list, and I'm like, no, I'm definitely getting you a Chromebook.
Does he know he wants Windows because he wants to do something that requires Windows?
No. That was just my question, because I saw, when I was at Fry's, I saw a Chromebook and a Cloudbook, and I'm like, what is a Cloudbook?
Yeah, it's a Windows machine.
Yeah, okay.
It's a cheap Windows machine. I don't recommend them, even if you need to use Windows.
Okay, yeah, because he has a regular laptop, so.
Yeah, he can always use that if he needs to.